I'm going to play something for you, and I want to see what you think of a particular chord. I'll let you know what chord it is right before it plays so you can hear which one it is. 'Cause I'd already know. What do you think? Was it pretty? Are you neutral about it? Was it weird sounding or even bad? Hold that thought for a second. So a good friend of mine who saw my video on the ZZ Top 7 chord, link below, mentioned to me that I should do that horrible more than words chord. When I asked him what he was talking about, he said that when the song first came out, there was a lot of buzz in his circle about how pretty the song was, with the exception of that one particular awful sounding chord that just made everybody cringe. He sent me a link with the minutes and seconds to the chord, so I listened to it. And I actually thought it sounded pretty. This was instantly intriguing to me, and I decided I had to do a video on it. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the weird more than words chord. This free lesson is an intermediate advanced lesson since I'm going to be getting into some advanced chord theory later. However, don't click away just yet because the chord itself is stupid easy and you don't really have to know why it works to be able to play it. So you can of course skip past the explanation part. I try to index all my videos to make it easy to skip between sections so you can jump straight to the parts you want. Now, there are a few cool chords in this song, but the chord I'm going to be talking about today happens only once in the song and near the very end. I'll play it again for you from the original recording, then I'll play it on my guitar so you can hear it in context with no vocal distractions. 'Cause I'd already know. Now, like I said, I personally like the sound of this chord. I think it's pretty. When I told my friend about this, he was pretty surprised. I did disclaimer the fact that I'm a seasoned music professional with a pretty extensive knowledge of weird jazz chords and a jaded musical ear that likes this kind of stuff. But to be fair, my friend has been in bands himself, plays several instruments, and writes music of his own on the side. And when I let my fiance with almost no musical experience listen to it, she just shrugged her shoulders and said, it sounded neat. So I figured it must be one of those, what color is this dress, blue or gray kind of things. Probably just an individual perception or taste thing. Before I delve much deeper into the philosophy and use of the chord, let's actually take a look at the chord itself. First, a quick disclaimer. The guitarist, Nuno Bettencourt, was tuned down a half step on every string in the original recording, to the tuning E-flat, A-flat, D-flat, G-flat, B-flat, E-flat. So if you want to play along with the song, you'll have to tune all your strings a half step down. However, to skip past a bunch of disclaimers and transposing confusion for this video, I'm just going to go ahead and bump the original recording up a half step, so we can pretend like they are playing it in standard tuning. There we go. Now everything's easier to talk about. Here it is. Those of you familiar with the open D7 chord might notice that it is exactly the same fingering, except basically just slid up 3 frets. And that's how I recommend you try building this chord at first. Build a D7 by pretending that 4th fret marker doesn't exist on the diagram, then just slide everything up 1, 2, 3 frets with your fingers in the same position, and you've got the chord. This is actually pretty convenient if you want to learn the song, since that's exactly how it happens in the song. The D7 chord immediately followed by the weird chord. Notice those two X's telling you in this case to just start picking from the 4th or D string up, avoiding the E and A strings altogether, and just strumming those bottom 4 strings. For context, the song itself is in the key of G. The chord progression leading up to the weird chord on the syllable D of the line I already know are A minor 7, then D7, then the weird chord, resolving on the next measure to the root chord G and continuing with the rest of the chord progression, like this. I already know. Although I have seen several different namings of this chord, I personally see it as a D7 flat 9. I'm not saying any other naming of this chord is wrong, it's more of a tomato-tomato thing, since I've found that the more advanced a chord is, the more likely it is to have several different ways of naming it. For those of you with some advanced chord building knowledge, I called it a D7 flat 9 because it's not only immediately preceded by a D7 chord, but its lowest sounding note is a D, and everything else about a D7 flat 9 fits into place. Root D, the flat 7C, the flat 9, that's an E flat, and the fifth A. A flat 9 chord is usually spelled with the root, third, fifth, flat 7, and flat 9 scale degrees, so almost everything falls into place. However, there's no third here, major or minor, leaving it open to interpretation. But since it's preceded with the D7 chord right before it, which is major, I gave this chord the benefit of the doubt and called it major too. Now I'll get into the deeper theory and use of this chord in a second, but let me take a second to mention that I agree with my friend in one respect. While I don't think the chord is ugly on its own per se, I do feel like it's completely out of place in this song. It not only happens just once, but it's such an exotic jazz chord in a song that's mostly simple majors and minors that it kind of sticks out like a sore thumb. I kind of feel like putting this chord in a song like this is like a dude in a pink cowboy outfit showing up at a wedding. A little out of place. To prove this, listen to how it sounds a little nicer when I jazz everything up a bit by surrounding it with other exotic jazz chords of its kind. See how it fits in a little better? Now, everything we just talked about is philosophically interesting, but there's another twist to this story that I've been leaving out. The vocals. One of the singers is on the lower vocal part with a C note in our pitched up version, but that note's already accounted for in our D7 flat 9. That's the flat 7 chord tone, so no problems there. But the higher vocal note in our standard tuning version is a G. That G is a whole step below the high A note that the guitar is playing, which creates an interval of a major second, or a whole step apart. There's the dissonance. This additional note makes the perceived chord a D7 flat 9 sus 4, which not only makes that missing third more ambiguous, but it makes that cowboy suit we were talking about even more colorful and out of place. To prove this, I'll play our chord once with the original vocal note of the G, then I'll do it again, but raise the G I sing up to an A note that matches with the high chord tone of the guitar, and the dissonance should disappear. I already... There's a dissonance.
I already...
So, in a way, I have to concede to my friend's point. It's not the guitar chord that is so dissonant, but all the notes you hear while the chord is playing, which kind of works out to be the same thing. However, here's the kicker. I still think it's a pretty chord. This is a tricky one to answer since it's an open chord, which limits your options to only this chord in only this key since it's not movable. Simply put, I would say that if you're playing a song in the key of G, and you have a D or D7 chord come along, you could probably use this chord as a substitute, since it's a flavor of D7. But I would exercise caution for the above reasons of it possibly sticking out like a sore thumb, depending on what comes before and after it. It's an exotic chord, and should be treated as such. But like most interesting chord choices, there's really only one way to find out, so experiment on a song-by-song basis and see if your ear likes it. Just be aware that others might not necessarily agree. If most of the stuff I talked about in this lesson left you a bit confused, or you even got some of it but want to further sharpen your music theory knowledge and playing skills, I recommend checking out the links below for how to sign up with me for online lessons. So what did you think? Does this chord sound nasty to you? Pretty? Nice but out of place? Did you not like it at first, but then it grew on you? I'm curious to see how different people hear this chord differently, so weigh in the comments section below. If you like my teaching style, be sure to check out my channel for more tutorial videos, and check the links below the videos for more teaching and music learning resources that I offer. I'm always adding to my video channel when I can, so check in often to see what's new. This is Tyson Farmer from TysonFarmer.com. Thanks for checking my channel out, and stay self-motivated and keep playing. See now.